Good morning, this is Lauren Teague from Laurencopia coming to you on April 1st, April Fools. But it's not April Fools. We're living in a sci-fi weirder land. Anyway, so I've been working in my garden, you know, getting things together, cleaning my house, hunkering down, staying home. Me and my coworkers are unemployed. I've been hitting food banks, which has been great. We've had several food drives in Tucker, so I'm very stocked up to get through this, and I've tried to attempt to keep as much social distancing as possible. But where are we right now? I was saying on my Facebook page that week six, if you look at China or even Italy and Iran, usually when you get back to week six, after the first death, it's not after the first reported case of infection. Usually it's the first death when someone dies in that country. You see an escalation of infections, and you see the first influx of deaths as resultant from the virus. So we are right now in America, the United States. We had our first infection on the 20th, and we discovered our first death on the 23rd. We hit week six right towards the ending of March, right about the time that I was laid off. And all people in various industries, like hotel industries and restaurant industries and that type of work, have been laid off, and even in other industries, but certainly us. I started warning people on January 9th about the coronavirus outbreak in China. And on the 23rd, when they quarantined Wuhan, I was saying on my Facebook page that we should have locked down international travel. Now, naturally, that was hard to achieve because you're talking about tanking the world's economy or putting it on hold, which is hard to grasp for a lot of people. Anyway, long story short, where are we now? Right now, we are at week nine in the United States. So we're seeing everything peak. If you look on Worldometer, which I've suggested to you before, it's a website that tracks life and death statistics and has been tracking the coronavirus since right around January 9th, maybe before. I discovered it on January 11th because my brother and I had looked at it several times when we had discussions about world population and how overpopulated we actually are. Anyway, so at week nine, what you're going to see over the next couple of weeks around Easter is you're going to see, and this is based upon what we've seen in China. Now, South Korea, for instance, put everything on lockdown immediately. They had an explosion of like 200 deaths from a church, or 200 infections from a church. I'm sorry, not deaths. The 200 infections from a church, and they immediately went on lockdown. And you're noticing they're not seeing the same results as you're seeing in Italy and the United States and in other countries who are just starting out. They're fairly far into this, about as far as Iran and Italy are. Italy is suffering a great deal. The United States is not suffering a great deal yet, but we're seeing our infection rate go up so high that we have surpassed China. As of the first, we definitely surpassed China. And in fact, I think New York City has surpassed China in infections, or the infections they reported. Now, we have questions about China because they're a communist country, and there's a tendency, just like there was here in the United States, to pretend like things weren't going on until they started to show up and you couldn't ignore them. And then there was a point where, you know, it's possible that they were trying to preserve their economy, and they may have underreported or ceased to report accurately. Now, it's possible that they are reporting accurately, and I don't want to bash them because we'll see in a couple of weeks as it results everywhere else in the world. But anyway, so at week nine, even in China, we saw a kind of a plateau where everything got like to really large numbers and the death rate started to jump up. Right now, worldwide, the death rate is at 19%. That climbed in the last 5 days from 14% to 15% to 16% to 17% to 18%. It hung at 18% for about 2 days. It's been hanging at 19% for 2 days. It's possible that it could go up. because all of the cases that are infected are beginning to have outcomes in stages. You have a stage of about supposedly 14 days, maybe as long as 27 days, according to what we know from China. So where we are right now, we're in week 9, and we are going to see if it follows the same pattern, we're going to see an exponential growth that will be highly recognizable because of the large number of people that are infected and also the large number of people that are succumbing to it. And the only way we can gauge the death rate right now is based upon cases with an outcome. Those are people that were infected and have been through the whole period of infection, and they either recover or they die. And that's what I'm basing, and Worldometer is basing, the 19% death rate on. Now, when we first started with the outbreak, the death rate was like 1%. Very negligible. And that grew exponentially over time as more countries began to experience infections and deaths in the waves of the period of time that it took them to result in an outcome. So you're going to see that rise. New York is prime for this infection because of the fact that they are built in such a way that you have a population of eight and a half million people living in close proximity. Now in Atlanta, we probably have 6 million people living in what they consider to be Metro Atlanta. That's not actually the city of Atlanta. It's everything, including my city and the cities surrounding, that are considered part of Metro Atlanta. And Atlanta has a lot of people on the outlying areas that probably make up another 2 million people. So we probably have the population of New York in the area that comes in and out of Atlanta, but we're not stacked on top of each other in high rises. And being stacked on top of each other the way that you live in New York, and having so many people packed in such small square mileage, it's hard to social distance, and thus we are seeing a high infection rate in that particular city. We're seeing it coming out in other states too, but I would imagine that New York is going to get hardest just because of the way that the infrastructure of that city is developed, and the way that people live and how close in proximity they live to each other. So hopefully, if things go the way that I have observed them to, we should see in the next 2 to 3 weeks the apex of infections. And then you should see, and this is based upon China, because China's the only one that's really had an outcome other than South Korea, and there are two different ways of approaching it, and two different instances. South Korea knew it existed. I think South Korea, by the time it hit South Korea, we already had testing kits. When it hit China, we did not really, for the first couple of weeks, and we didn't have them all over the world. But what I'm saying from that, though, is if we are looking at China, China had a plateau somewhere around like week 10 after the first death. So as we are approaching week 9, week 10, week 11, which will be right around Easter holiday here, middle of April, we may see it begin to gradually recede. And that's just based upon what I'm seeing reported. It's not necessarily accurate because we really don't know. We're reporting for ourselves in the United States and in other countries accurately. And we'll know when it's all said and done. But here's hoping that April will be when we start to see things decrescendo. Hopefully. All right. Lauren Cheek from Lauracopia at the Cheek Farm. That's my update. I'll try to update you again. By the way, Prince Charles recovered, or he's recovering. He looks good. He did an Instagram thing today. There are lots of famous people that are succumbing to it, and that's kind of making it hit home. But we're all hunkered down. Try to take it seriously. Try to keep your social distancing as much as possible. And be safe. Wash your hands. Also, in another video, I reported that alcohol was good for killing the virus, which is true, but what I learned since then is that it must be 60 to 70% alcohol. So rubbing alcohol is a good alternative to bleach or something if you want to sanitize your hands and you don't have hand sanitizer. And if you have hand sanitizer or a cleaning agent, it should contain, 60 to 70% alcohol, or it should contain bleach. Ammonia is not necessarily the best alternative. Windex is not a good alternative, but vinegar, kills viruses. So there are your top three. All right, good luck, and may the odds be in your favor.